What's up, weirdos? Immediately, I want to say this is not a SZA hate video. This is not me saying that the stuff I'm talking about means that SZA is a bad person or deserving of hate, but it is a very interesting thing that's going on. And she's like a massive celebrity, super successful, super wonderful. Her music is great. I love SZA. SZA stands. This is not a me hating SZA video, please. In addition to that, though, there is some stuff that's like about SZA that's really interesting and we can just, like, it can just be funny. The situation is funny, okay? Whew, okay, I'm just trying to start off with the clarification there so that I don't, you know, get dragged through the mud by SZA stans. When her album came out, I listened to it cover to cover. SZA is a fantastic artist. I love her. But if you don't know why SZA is being talked about right now and why I'm making this video, let me just clarify real quick. So this TikToker right here, Vadalore, shared an experience that she had with SZA where SZA was fist fighting her in the Instagram DMs, which is objectively kind of funny when you're a massive, successful, mega celebrity like SZA. SZA is huge. This isn't like some underground artist, you know, getting offended and then messaging somebody. This is like SZA. It is interesting and it is funny, especially when we go through the DMs themselves, because there's a lot. But again, as we're going through this, please understand, I am not saying that SZA is a bad person. She is a good person who, in this moment, said some stuff that's kind of funny, but we can still have empathy for her and see where she's coming from and relate to her on a human level. Okay, well, let's get there. I feel like I've clarified enough so we can get into this.
So I went to the SOS tour and there's this like viral meme that was posted like a couple years ago. You know, this is a whack.
So she's giving context there. And if you're not familiar with this, because she didn't really give context, there was like a viral clip that went around of somebody at the SZA concert and they were like recording the SZA concert and then her phone just says SZA whack on the Instagram story. I'll just show you the clip. So that's the clip that went viral, and you might be thinking, okay, innocuous, not that big of a deal, but SZA saw it because it kind of blew up, and then it made her feel insecure about performing live, and it was like, ugh, that is a sucky thing to see. No matter how successful you are, no matter how big you are, I can understand why that personally would be tough. It's just also, in addition to that, that happens to like every celebrity, and most people just ignore it because they know that engaging with it makes things worse. But you can't deny that that thing itself would like, it's like, it's kind of relatable for her to be like, this sucks. Anyways, this fan who's making this video, who has the beef with SZA, recreated that meme. In my opinion, it's just her doing a reference to the viral meme. It's not her actually coming at SZA saying that SZA sucks. Sorry, I've got my defense jacket on. It's made of suede. Actually, I don't know what suede is. This is just a Gen Z type thing, okay? Like, it's funny, it's just a reference. She's not posting it for SZA to see. She's posting it as a reference for her followers and her friends to see. Okay, so she did that. And then SZA did this.
So I posted it to my 250 Instagram followers and then SZA commented this.
Yeah, she posted it for her Instagram followers. By the way, yeah, this fan is not like a massive public figure, like an Anthony Fantano. She has 250 Instagram followers. She posted that and then SZA went out of her way to go comment this on the post. I don't think you realize how fucked up that actually is and how hurtful it was back then and how it ruined my confidence and desire to perform live. Y'all not human and it's sad. Really wish you the best. Love. So that was what she commented on a random reference meme post on an account that has 250 followers. And you have to admit, objectively, when you are SZA, when you are a massive, massive celebrity, icon, superstar, you can't be going out of your way and commenting these things on random Instagram posts. Like that, okay, that is true. The deeper layer of that is we can also acknowledge her seeing that brought back some traumatic memories of when it blew up the first time and she felt really hurt by that and it ruined her confidence. So her feeling hurt by that is not something that we should be making fun of. It's not like, oh, LL. It's like, that is genuinely a relatable human thing to be feeling. But it's like, why comment? It objectively looks like you're caring too much about the haters and being a little bit sensitive. I don't want to say sensitive, but when you are that big of a celebrity, something kind of this small, an Instagram post for an account with 250 followers should not be able to affect you in a way that you then make it this big public thing. But before we keep going, because there's a lot more to talk about, I want to thank the sponsor of today's video, Scentbird. Scentbird is a monthly subscription that sends you the highest, best quality perfumes that you can even imagine. These are designer fragrances. Like, they have Tom Ford fragrances, they've got Gucci fragrances, they've got everything. And they send you them in these cute little Scentbird packages, and when you open it up, brace yourself. Very clean, very aesthetic, and to unlock it and spray, you just go like this. Turn the nozzle over here, and then you can just, yeah, yeah. Oh, that's, wait, that smells really good. And to see what the specific scent is in each one, it's so cute, like magnetic. Look at that. Look at that, look at that. You just open it up and they come with these cute little cards that show you like what the fragrance like is, like with a description of the fragrance and the specific things that it gives hints of. So Good Habit by Paws has pink pepper, jasmine, vanilla blossom, musk, cedarwood. Now the next one, see what I'm saying? Like the packaging is beautiful. Oh my God, you know, just by the name of it, I was like, this is for a handsome young man. And I like to hope that I am one. Let's see what it smells like. Oh, that is good. Okay, yeah, this one's Ember by Joseph Abor. So this is apple, fresh citrus, incense, smoked sandalwood, dark leather. The third one, Purple Noon by Uso Vert. I've never seen the packaging like this. This is a really, really cute bottle. It has notes of ginger, Tunisian neroli oil, geranium, Indian tuberose, and musk. You know it's designer and you know it's fancy when you're hearing ingredients that you didn't even know of. I smell it so good. And Simbert is giving you these designer scents at an actually affordable price, for real. And the fact that they make these scents more accessible to people, it's just, it's something that I really do genuinely support. And I think that it's really great. And I think that more people should smell nice. And the way to get more people to smell nice, just click the link in my description and use code FCooper to get 55% off your first month at Simbert. I love Simbert. They're so nice. And I love you very much. Now back to the video, because there's so much to talk about. Because the thing is, her feeling that way, completely valid. Her feeling hurt, completely valid. Her posting that also doesn't make her a bad person, because she is not thinking SZA is gonna see that. It's not like she DM'd SZA, hey, you're whack. Like, she didn't do that meme. She's doing the reference to a very viral thing, not thinking that the massive, insanely popular mega celebrity of SZA is actually gonna see it. So the people who are going crazy hard on this fan are also kind of lost in the sauce, in my opinion, because how could she know? It's not like she went up to SZA in her face and was like, you're whack. It's the reference, SZA. She's just doing her thing. We can have empathy for everybody here because the world is not a Marvel movie with a clinically evil character and a clinically good character, okay? I don't know why I'm doing this at you. I'm not gonna chop you in the neck. But so far, can we just have empathy for both of these people and realize that there's nuance? In addition to this, this fan posting this video, it's kind, you kind of have to understand why she would post this, because it's objectively very interesting. Like, this is social media. SZA did this, it's understandable that she would post it and not be like, but it gets worse and there's more layers to this. I'm just trying to set us on a path where it's not like SZA is perfect and this fan should be given insane amounts of hate. This person did not sign up for a superstar, you know, celebrity status, but she did post this, and by posting this, you kind of open yourself up to criticism. But Vatalore, this fan, I don't think that people should be going insanely hard on her for this. We gotta have some empathy, we gotta have some understanding, but let's keep going because it gets a little bit wacky.
I deleted it because I was embarrassed. And she also DM'd me and said, not okay, space period. So I was like, oh my God, why is this in my DM?
So she deleted it, which seems like it should have been the ending of it, because she saw that SZA was hurt by it. Nope, I'm reading it right now and deleted my comment. She deleted SZA's comment. Okay, okay. Okay. Me, I would delete the post at that point because clearly it hurt SZA, and I would delete the post because it's not that serious. So at this point, I'm like, okay, I'm seeing a little bit more of like, hey, just delete the post. It's not that serious. But then Vatalore, the fan, is like, I guess seeing an opportunity here. Anyways, yeah, SZA following it up with a DM, not okay, period. It's like, again, same point, SZA probably shouldn't be DMing every single fan that has anything like kind of negative or meme-y. Like, you can't be DMing random people with 250 followers. That's in my opinion. Also, SZA is not just like some character that exists. She's a real person with real feelings. And okay, she DM'd somebody because she was hurt by it. What? That make her a bad person? No. But then the fan says, sorry, it was just a joke. It could end after that. It could. But then SZA says, LMAO, and you kept it up after I told you how that made me feel as a human being? For laughs? Take care, love. Thank you for coming. Then, no response. Then, and deleted my comment? Wow, lol. And then no response, and then another thing. It's like, you see why this is a story? You see why this is interesting? Because it's not like the fan was harassing SZA, and then SZA was like giving a couple like one word responses here, and then the story's getting spun out of nowhere. It is objectively interesting to see somebody who is the status of SZA going so hard on somebody for a reference to a meme. That's true. We can have empathy for SZA though, and we should have empathy for SZA. Her next thing says, before I block you, I just want to remind you I'm a person. Like, I have feelings and a life and anxiety like anyone else. It's really hard to have courage to get up on stage and even want to do my job. My feelings matter. I don't bother anyone, and being the butt of a joke is just the issue. You're popular. Doesn't make it better or okay. Peace. Oh, not just the issue. Just because you're popular doesn't make it better or okay. Okay. And hey, I've been saying that. SZA is a person and it's okay to have empathy for her, and this is clearly the straw that broke the camel's back. It's not like this just one thing happened in a vacuum out of nowhere and then she went like on this person. Obviously SZA has gotten a lot of stuff, and currently at that time I'm sure she was just dealing with a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety, and that one thing was like, oh, the reference to the most like traumatic time in my life that made me not even want to perform live anymore. Yeah, that's great. Let me just go DM this person because this sucks. Like, life sucks. It's okay to be going through a mood like that and to be feeling feelings. Like, feelings are okay and valid to be felt. Logically, and if you're thinking as a public figure, you shouldn't be doing this because this is a bad decision that nothing good is gonna come out of, but she's venting, she's getting her feelings out, she's expressing herself, and that's fine, and we shouldn't be penalizing somebody by expressing their hurt. This would not be insane if it was coming from somebody who wasn't a public figure, so it's also not insane to be coming from a public figure because everybody is a person, like SZA is saying. In addition to that, it is SZA, and it is kind of objectively like wild that this is even happening. Or I understand why they wanted to post it, because it is an interesting situation and it's kind of wild from their perspective to just be a regular person with 250 followers and then SZA out of nowhere DMs you all this stuff. But if you turn off your Gen Z content brain for a second and just think about what SZA is actually saying as a person, she's not saying anything that's that crazy. She's actually just expressing her feelings and telling you why what you did hurt her, and then you decide to hurt her, you know, by sharing this stuff. But I don't think that Vatilor should be getting sent a bunch of hate, you know? And I'm not trying to be a fence sitter here. I'm just saying, if we're objectively looking at this situation, I don't think that either person is a bad person for this. But you can look at it and break it down and be like, you know, there's something going on here that could have been handled differently by both people. God, I don't want to be moist critical. I don't want the fence sitter allegations. Okay, by the end of this video, I'm gonna have a strong take. And you can trust me on that. That's the guarantee. The next thing that happens is, like, it escalates a little bit. Something happens.
I was like, what? And while I was like reeling, this random account sent me this DM that's with zero women's fuck. And the account is like full of photos with SZA. This is SZA's friend. SZA's friend came after me. So I sent a message back that was like, why, you're 15 years older than me, why are you coming after me?
Okay, a lot of stuff to break down there for a second. So SZA was so hurt by this that she told her friend, and then her friend also DM'd this girl with 250 followers. At some point, you just gotta turn off your phone. If this is what's going on, you just gotta turn off your phone, like for real. There comes a time when responding actually makes it way worse. Stick to your gut, express your feelings, and then if people still aren't respecting like your feelings or being mean to you, you just gotta turn off your phone. Trust me. Cause then this girl says, girl, please, you're literally, she didn't show the full message, but it goes, you're literally coming after an 18-year-old girl recreating a meme that was posted like 3 years ago. Why are you coming after me so hard and sicking your friends on me? You're 15 years older than me and it's a reoccurring meme in the fan base and no one genuinely means it. You're a multiple time Grammy nominee and you've so many awards, like obviously you aren't whack. It's situational irony and I thought it was funny to recreate that on the floor of your sold out tour. Like, I spent $350 on those tickets. Obviously, I don't think you're whack. I clearly enjoyed your concert, so I don't know why you're coming after me as if you don't have 15 million followers on Insta and the top album of the century. Please just focus on yourself and relationship. Blah, 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 blah. Honestly, this 18-year-old girl kind of spitting right here. This is all very valid, and I would hope that SZA would react to this with some sort of healing. Because Vatilor here, I wish I knew her name, so I'm not just calling her Vatilor the whole time. She is being like very complimentary and saying, yes, I did this, but let me really explain to you why I did this and why I don't think that it should be something that should affect you because I love you so much, you're incredible, like giving her so much praise while also explaining like, hey, it's really just a joke, like I'm not actually insulting you, like it's just a joke. And you would hope that the response SZA would have to this is, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, I overreacted, but it's just something that really affects me, and I know it's a meme within the community, but it does have this attachment to the trauma that I had when it first happened, so when I see it, it really hurts me. Thank you so much for coming out to the tour. But if you could delete that post, I would really appreciate it. Something like that to kind of, you know, mend it. If you're trying to mend it and accept the apology, then you would, but also, you know, I can understand how this message would be received as invalidating your feelings. I can understand that. But on the other hand, you would just hope that you would take this as an opportunity to, you know, move on. And it sucks that SZA didn't do that because her response that follows is why this story has really blown up. And again, we have to have empathy for her. I can understand why this last message would hit SZA in a way that's like diminishing her feelings. I can understand where SZA still feels hurt by this. I don't know what makes you think that because I'm famous or older than you, I'm not allowed to have feelings. I haven't sucked anyone on you.
Huh?
I didn't read that first. Oh man, I love SZA. God, is this making me the biggest SZA fan of the century? I love SZA. That is so funny. I haven't sucked anyone on you. God, if that was on purpose, oh man, it wasn't. She's trying to say I haven't sicked anyone on you. Girl, why are you coming after me? I literally haven't even sucked anyone on you. I didn't even get three guys piled on you and then suck them. I didn't even do that. Sorry, I gotta get it together. Oh my God. I don't know what makes you think that because I'm famous or older than you, I have not allowed to have feelings. I haven't sucked anyone on. Sorry. It's not that funny. It's just that I thought that she genuinely said that. I don't know what makes you think that because I'm famous or older than you, I'm not allowed to have feelings. I haven't sucked anyone on you. I just gotta move on. You chose to make this meme. I didn't even post about it. Lol. Yikes. No one's attacking you. I'm actually... Okay. Also, to SZA's point. Yeah, SZA's not attacking her. This girl is acting like SZA was attacking her, which I can understand why she feels that way because a massive celebrity is expressing her emotions passionately. But what's wrong with a 33-year-old woman passionately expressing her emotions and sharing her feelings and being vulnerable? Why we gotta interpret that as angry? Huh? Because there's something to be said for interpreting SZA's passionate speech as anger, and I'm not the one to say anything about that, but if we're really looking at the messages, she's not coming across as angry. She's just coming across as, hey, you probably shouldn't be saying this to a random person online. But it's fine, and we have empathy because she is a person. She said that earlier. Ooh, yeah, it kept going. No one's attacking you. I'm actually talking to you like a real person. I wish you could do the same. It's called empathy, humanity, and honest communication. I didn't curse at you, call you names, or send anyone your way, or say anything about it publicly. Lol. I literally just said, hey, this isn't cool. This original meme was a huge part of my state anxiety I had for years. This hurt my feelings. And instead of saying, aw, man, I get that, and I'm sorry, you deleted my comment and laughed. No one's coming after you. Just told you to blocking you after being really kind and respectful. She is spitting. Okay, you know what? I'm kind of on SZA's side here. Yeah, I told you I'd have a strong take. I think, oh dang. Cause me just reading the headlines, I was like, SZA, what are you doing? Me reading the conversation, SZA is not being mean or attacking this fan. SZA is on a human level communicating, but it's, you know, I understand why this is a story because the person has 250 followers and you should just be ignoring it so that this type of situation doesn't happen. Also, if we're looking at the messages on a human level, not from a social media Gen Z brain type of perspective, on a actual empathetic human level, she is only expressing how she was hurt and how that meme caused her anxiety. It's just a little bit odd because she has 15 million followers. This girl has 250 followers and was posting it as a reference to a meme at a concert that she paid to be at. So if SZA had thought about this fully from that perspective, then I can assume that she probably wouldn't have commented that or sent any of these messages. But you cannot expect every public figure and every celebrity to fully think about every single consequence and every single implication. They're also just human beings and we can have empathy for them. And on my mother, I have empathy for SZA. That's true. Even in this message right here, like you're posting this screenshot of all these messages from SZA. And if I'm just blanking out, not reading the messages, I'm thinking like, damn, that's crazy. But I unblur my vision, I read the words, and I'm seeing a woman who is affected by the thing that was posted and is communicating why it hurt her. And that is something that I can have empathy for, okay? Okay? And I think that this TikTok brain idea of, oh, like, oh, content, oh, this is gonna be a good meme. You're kind of ignoring everything that SZA is saying here about how this type of thing affects her. And by posting this, you are basically taking a personal shot at her. You would take a personal shot at me, Skip! Do you guys know that clip? Okay, by the way, I am definitely trying to get you involved in like the sports commentary world of memes. They're so good. Please, please. They're like modern day Wendy Williams. Skip Bayless is my current day Wendy Williams. And that's a fact. Listen to this.
Still playing at a high level at 45 when you had to stop at 35.
Okay, right there, Skip Bayless is talking about Tom Brady, how he's still playing at a high level at 45. And he's saying that the guy on the left, Shannon Sharp, is jealous of that fact. And then look what happens.
No, I don't take personal shots. You started it.
Time out. You would take a personal shot at me.
I didn't take a personal shot at you.
Wait a minute.
What are you talking about?
This is my Wendy Williams. You see, this is dramatic. Anyways, the whole point of that is you would take a personal shot at me. Hold on. God, I wish you watched this stuff. I know some of y'all do. Anyways, what? SZA responding like, you would take a personal shot at me. Is that what I was talking about? Basically, the point is, SZA is being a human. SZA is communicating this on a human level, and the Gen Z TikTok fan here is choosing to go, okay, I could make her emotional state worse. And then she posts it, and she does. That does not mean that we should all be sending a bunch of hate to Vedalore. Vedalore, Vedalore? Vedalore. Vedayor. Vedayor. I'm not saying that. I understand why she posted this, and I get that it's technically interesting. I think that it's not respecting SZA on a human level, but I don't think that that makes Vedayor a bad person. Especially not one deserving of the 15 million followers of SZA's objective and direct hatred. Okay? Is that fair to say? I think that that is fair to say, and I'm taking a clear stance that SZA has done nothing wrong. To this point, let's continue. And then she said, sorry, sick anyone on you. Lol, not sucked. I also have an amazing relationship with my fans. I'm so grateful for them. I love SZA! Sorry, sick anyone on you. Lol, not sucked. She gets it. She's funny. She's so, I think, in my delusional mind, that SZA and I could be best friends. We could technically be best friends. That's my opinion. But that's me.
But that's me.
That's so funny. I'm glad that she acknowledged that, because that is funny. But then Vedayor says, no, you were rude about it and never worded it in that nature. You should have simply said, hey, thanks for coming, but the last slide really upsets me. If you want positive constructive criticism, you have to give positive constructive criticism. Okay, I understand that, Vedayor, but you cannot ask somebody's response to your hurt to be perfect. What's that line Emily Blunt says in Oppenheimer? Kitty Oppenheimer, after she finds out that Robert Oppenheimer cheated on her, and then Jean Tatlock, the girl that Robert Oppenheimer cheated on his wife with, when she passes away, then, you know, Oppenheimer's sad and he's lost it. Then Kitty Oppenheimer comes up and says, you don't get to commit the sin and then ask all of us to feel sorry for you when there are consequences. And that is what I'm saying to the fan. You committed the sin. You were hurtful to SZA. Listen, you didn't mean to be. We know that you didn't mean to be. But the reality is that that is a very personal trauma that SZA has dealt with. And then when SZA sees that, there are consequences. And the consequences are SZA expressing her hurt by that. Not saying that you suck and that you are a bad person, but saying, hey, this really hurts me. And now you're posting this asking us to feel sorry for you because you hurt somebody and they express that they were hurt. Just because she's a massive celebrity doesn't mean that she can't express her hurt and you respect it. It is objectively, again, a bad idea to do that. SZA should not have done that because now this has happened and this is what happens when you do what SZA did. This is the natural consequence of that. And in order to have this whole blown up situation not happen, you have to just ignore it. That is true. In addition to that, if we're looking at this situation not from content brain Gen Z perspective, but from an actual human empathetic level, we can see that SZA was not being mean. She was not being aggressive. She was passionately explaining why it hurt her. Even if she shouldn't have been doing it, even if she should have ignored it, the things that she was saying are not insane for her to be saying. Whew. But that's me.
But that's me.
And see, and then SZA, you know, keeps responding. It's turned into a whole argument, and this is obviously taking up a lot of SZA's mind space during this day. Like, she's really thinking about this, so she is responding a lot. She's just saying, like, it wasn't funny, it lacked humanity, I don't need criticism, I was just letting you know something hurt my feelings. LMAO, I don't understand. You can make a meme, but I can't think it's not funny, and respond, you literally tagged me, love. She did tag her. You know what? You can't tag somebody in something like that and then get mad when they see it. Why else are you tagging them? Yeah. 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 Like, if I've ever tagged Harry Styles in a video where I'm doing, I'm Harry Styles, and he's like, hey, that's kind of dumb. Which, by the way, I've heard through people that he thinks it's funny. I don't know if that's true. I'm not going to be delusional, but I have heard through people that, like, met him in real life and done that reference to him that he has, he's seen it and he thinks that it's funny. They could be lying. They could be lying. They could be just saying that to get attention from me and to get me to respond. But I'm just saying, if in another world, Harry was like really sensitive and he thought that that was like insulting to him, if he thought that that was insulting and he commented or DM'd me and was like, hey, this is really hurtful, you know what I would do? Stop doing it. I wouldn't argue back with him and be like, no, I love you. That's why I get to tag you and be a little shithead. I'm not trying to be a shithead, but I wouldn't fight back. I would have empathy because he's a human being, just like SZA is a human being, and passionately expressing your hurt should be heard on a human level. Okay? Okay? Okay, okay, okay. By the way, I started this video with like a whole thing of like, don't get mad, don't get mad, don't get mad. Cause I was afraid that as it was going on through this, it would be a little bit more even in my mind. But really taking the time and looking into the words, I don't think that this widespread criticism of SZA for this situation is warranted.
A comment like, what are you gonna do? Call the media and be like, oh my God, this bitch Maya said that I was whack. Like, what are you gonna do?
But she continued, said, I also thanked you for coming, Law, right here. I've been really respectful. She has been. Didn't even have to be this deep. That's also true. And probably in the future, she won't be that deep and she won't be that vulnerable with a fan who's hurt her because obviously it's been turned and weaponized against her. So now her vulnerability is just apparently bad because it can be, you know, used in the way that Vedeyor is doing it. And again, I can understand why Vedeyor thought that this was a funny, like, crazy situation, because it's crazy from her perspective for this to have happened. Yeah, but I don't think that SZA is the one who should be getting hate for this. I think that this should have just flopped, and that there should be like 100 comments on Vedeyor's video of, hey, she was actually being respectful. Like, it should have started, ended, and died there. It shouldn't have blown up to this level. But because it has been to that level, I feel like I gotta come out and I gotta put the dukes up for SZA. Because SZA has not done anything that is, like, wrong and makes her a bad person in this, okay? She said, I could have just blocked you and nothing, but instead I tried to dialogue. My mistake. Sorry. Take care. Thanks again for coming. That's what, like, the whole conversation was. Oh, no. It keeps going. Okay, she says, genuinely didn't think you'd feel attacked. The fan responded and said, I didn't think you would feel attacked too. I didn't mean any harm, but you also could have went about it differently, and you at first never asked me to delete it off the bat. I didn't know it gave you anxiety, and it have just been a private DM from the start. Good luck with your show in DC tomorrow. Heart. Okay, so they're making up. They're making up! But I am gonna be honest, as she's recording this video, look how she's saying it.
She said she's been really respectful and it didn't have to be this deep. It really didn't, but she was the one who kept, like, bringing it up. I was like, oh, I'm sorry. She was the one who wouldn't just leave it alone.
See what I mean? It's like, okay, the conversation seems pretty respectful. Seems like it's kind of ended it. But Vedeyor now is kind of taking it back, being like, well, she's actually, you know, wrong. And you know what? This whole resolution, actually, no, she sucks. And I think that that's a bad look. What she said to SZA right there, that's nice. And that's, you know, that's a good way to be like, I didn't know, blah, blah, blah. Like, that's great. But then her being like, she said she wasn't tagging me. I don't know about that. Like, it's a little bit shady and it's a little bit, I'm trying to get the last word with you not having an opportunity to respond. And I think that that is Gen Z brained and should be not what your response is. Also, she's an 18-year-old girl. She's a teenager. It's not like she has the life experience to understand how bad this is. But that doesn't mean that she can just get away with anything by saying, I'm just an 18-year-old teenager. It's not that serious. I'm just an 18-year-old teenager. So what? So whatever, I can't be mean to anybody ever forever. It's like, but you know, she's also 18. 18 is one of those ages, you know what I mean? It's like, hey, you are an adult, but also, I don't know if you really understand how immature this is. Like, this is very immature. And that is why Jerry Seinfeld, at 38, should not have been dating a 17-year-old. But that's me.
But that's me.
Got him. Anyways, let's keep going. SZA responded to that with, I genuinely felt like what you did was rude. I expressed myself honestly. I'm allowed to do that. I'm a person. Thank you. I hope it goes well. You tagged me. I responded. That's all. I don't wish you any ill at all. And again, I'm gonna be honest. SZA is 33 years old. I don't know if we can be taking all these periods as, you know, her being a mean, harsh jerk. I think we could interpret it as Facebook mom punctuation. You know when you text your parents and you're like, hey, I really love you and you're the most important person in my life and you're just so great and I care about you so much, and they send a thumbs up? To them, that thumbs up means the world. Even though to us, it's like, what? And we gotta remember, you know, SZA's 33 years old. So this punctuation doesn't necessarily have to be interpreted as her being rude and mean. I never cursed or called you names either. You said I wasn't human and I took it as an insult. I didn't know the intention of that comment was to take down the post. Wishing you the best. That's not what SZA was saying. SZA didn't say you aren't human. She said that what you were doing was lacking humanity on a human level, an empathetic level of humanity, because she was treating SZA like she wasn't a human in SZA's heart and how SZA felt. Then SZA responded, I loved your slide. Just thought the recreating of a viral meme that was created to bully me was kind of rude and lacked humanity. Lol. See? We can make up. We can make up and we can all be friends. Unfortunately, there's more. Vedeyor said, I understand where you're coming from more now, because at first the way you worded it came off as rude. Just leave it alone. Just, oh my God, can you not? Ugh. Just saying, as someone in your fan base, I can tell you it's a joke everyone laughs at because of the ridiculousness of it. And it really is just situational irony. It was just a silly joke in your fan base. And you can't slip in sneak disses. You can't. Okay, here's Therapy Cooper. When you are at the point in the disagreement or the argument where it's time to make up and you are both clearly taking steps to make up and you're both like, okay, just wrapping up the few things about like fully making sure that your feelings were heard and letting them know that their feelings were heard, you can't continue to sneak in little disses and jabs and then be like, what? What? The rest of the mess? I was just so sweet. What about the part where I said I understand where you're coming from? That is immature. When you're in an argument, when you're in a disagreement, That is the time where you swallow your pride and you say, no, I hear you, I understand you, I don't have to be fully right. I can understand where you're coming from and I can have empathy for you and I can love you through this disagreement. But when you throw in a little sneak diss and then act like, like surprised about it, that's immature and that's really. I kept hitting those reallys and I thought there was might be something to end it. Not nice? Got him!
You need to take a chill pill. You can have your feelings and everything, but when you're famous on such a wide scale.
Okay, by the way, not to be too critical, the LA accent right now with what she's saying is so annoying. You need to take a chill pill because when you're famous on such a wide scale. By the way, it is not just girls who have the LA accent. I specifically have overheard conversations in LA. I visited there twice, not to brag, where someone was saying, yeah, she's like a Chicago 10, but like an LA 6. Those were words that I heard. Describing somebody as a Chicago 10, but a LA 6. By saying it like that, this is just me coming from a Midwesterner perspective. I'm a Midwesterner. When I pass somebody in a grocery store, I say, oopsie daisies. Not even on purpose. Not even as a joke. Not even as a meme. I go, oopsie daisies. By myself. For nobody. So when I see someone saying, take a chill pill, I go, what? You're not gonna be nice after somebody just communicated that they were feeling very hurt? What? She just keeps going, I don't even wanna read that shit. And then SZA ends it with, thank you for coming, take care. Okay, that's the end. And then, look at how Vedeyor continues to get the last final word in this situation. In my opinion, SZA has not done anything wrong other than make the miscalculated mistake of expressing her feelings to a random person on Instagram. SZA's biggest crime here is expressing that she was hurt and acting like a human being to another human being. And I understand, and I am also acknowledging that when you're at that level, the only response that's gonna come from this is this type of response. That doesn't mean that it's okay. It means that she was not, you know, fully thinking about what her actions were gonna do. She was just thinking about, I need to express this because I'm very hurt in this moment and I need to feel hurt. So it sucks. And look at how Vedeyor ends this video.
She was like, you wanted me to see that. Bitch, you have 17 million Instagram followers. I tagged you. I didn't think you were gonna see it because like a million people tagged you.
That is fair. I can understand. Like, oh, tagging. Oh, because it's SZA. So I tagged SZA. Also, hey, understand when you tag somebody, there is a fat chance that they're gonna see it because people exist on social media. Like, lesson learned. Don't tag somebody if you're doing something like this. Okay, lesson learned. Don't then go like, take a chill pill. Like, obviously this is gonna happen. So I don't know why you're coming after me so hard. It's like, not that serious. Hey, did you hear anything that SZA was saying? Did you process anything that she was saying about how it hurt her and how you making this video is directly going against the resolution of the argument? Everything that SZA was communicating to you on a human level, you are turning on its head and saying, blah, blah, blah. It's like, really? Again, she's an 18-year-old girl. She is objectively just immature. The ending of this where she's just throwing unprovoked shots. She's taking a personal shot at SZA? SZA watching this video would be like, you would take a personal shot at me. There we go. It's just a lot of like, hey, you're wrapped up in your own world right now. You think that you're the main character. You think that everybody's gonna look at this post and agree with you. And unfortunately, a lot of people are taking the side of the fan on this. And then in addition, basically attacking SZA and bringing up, you know, a bunch of BS about her. People are mad at SZA and bullying SZA and being like, nope, honestly, she kind of ate. SZA actually is whack, all because of this. That's really sucky. And I think it's coming from people who aren't empathetic and don't have any sort of human connection or nuance when they see these things. They just go, ooh, big celebrity, send big message. Ooh, big celebrity obsessed. Ooh, big celebrity crazy. Hey, how about we stop calling women crazy when they express their feelings in respectful ways? That was very respectful. And Vedeyor is acting like it was an insane attack and that she is a bad person for it. And I think that that is immature and stupid. My strong take, Team SZA. I have always been Team SZA. Like, she's also just really funny. Like, all the memes of her just lying for no reason are hilarious. By the way, before I hear any BS about this, let me just acknowledge this. There's a lot of tweets of old screenshots of SZA tweets going, I don't get it. Neither Rihanna or Ciara can hold a note worth a damn. One's just worse than the other. So what's the beef? Or Beyonce looking more and more like Madonna every day. Could have swore she was black at one point, ... Hashtag, just saying. These tweets are both from 2011. And if I'm being honest, this is kind of a gotcha moment because it's like, okay, she tagged Rihanna, so the same thing can go. But SZA is now very popular and she sees what it's like to be on the receiving end of a tag on a negative post. And that evolution in her understanding, my little Australian voice, has led to her not to my knowledge, publicly tagging and crapping on Rihanna. I guess that this is a good example of her learning and growing and being a better, different person and understanding on a more human level how fame and this type of thing exists. Like, I don't think going back 12 years to find one tweet where she was pooping on a celebrity, it necessarily means that her expressing her emotions are invalid. Like, the tweet right here is, I don't care, the girl recreating the SZA whack meme is funny. Obviously, it's an ironic joke. For SZA to get mad tight and make a huge deal out of it, like, this girl started in the first place is crazy, especially since she used to talk mad shit about celebrities herself. Back it up. Hey, I love Lainey. Lonnie, is this a Lana Del Rey account? If it is, listen. I love Lana Del Rey. It is interesting how she goes, baby, you're so ghetto. I wouldn't say ghetto, but I also don't know the lore of that song. I don't know shit. Look at me. I don't know fucking shit. I'm an empty-headed little brain nugget bum. Nugget bum? What am I saying? What I'm trying to say here is people are treating this like it's a gotcha, saying, so for SZA to get mad tight and make a huge deal out of it, did she get mad tight and make a huge deal out of it though? Did she? Or are you just saying that because then it's a gotcha? Oh, y'all on SZA side? And then that gift, hey, I'm not going to war with you. I want no smoke with you. All I'm saying is that this isn't a gotcha because SZA was not mad tight. She wasn't getting mad tight at this girl. She wasn't even getting kind of tight. She was loose as hell, chilling in the DMs, just saying, hey, this is how my emotions are. Please take that into account. I feel hurt. But it's more funny if you ignore how she was actually talking and act like she was getting insanely mad at a random fan. It's more funny if you do that. So let's all collectively pretend that that's the case. It's not the case, babe. And again, thank you so much to Scentbird for sponsoring this video. Click the link in my description and use code FCooper to get 55% off your first month at Scentbird. But that's my opinion. I hope that you agree. I really do. And if you do or don't, please subscribe. Become a weirdo. I'm a weirdo.
I don't fit in. And I don't want to fit in. Have you ever seen me without this cool green shirt? A lot of album sales recently have honestly been really disappointing. Like Doja's album, like it really did not sell that well, which is shocking to me because it's Doja. And people want to be like, oh, well, it's because she's acting demon. Oh, so she turned her Christian fan base. Oh, shut up. She didn't have a massive Christian fan base who's acting like, oh, I can't listen to her now. Shut up. Christians who are that sensitive already weren't listening to Doja. Let's be real. They're just acting like, oh, well, here's a good reason to hate her. Boycott Doja, as if you were going to listen to anything other than Morgan Wallen anyways.